That's a lot of weight on the end of some forks. Just like that, it's in the back of the truck. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do when I get it back to the shop though. I'm not sure I'm gonna get it down the ramp. I'm not sure what I'm gonna get the post in. We'll work it out when we get home.
Yeah, I know. Probably a deck chair on the Titanic, but I really don't want this thing to turn over. They're only there for stability, because this thing weighs like 1,400 pounds. All right, so why a Penske truck? Well, I prefer this to the open center trailers that are available out there whenever you're doing this kind of stuff. U-Haul, Penske both use the same kinds of trailers. They're not a flat deck trailer. If you have access to a 16-foot flat deck trailer, it's gonna work a lot better. We don't, so we're having to go with the Penske truck route. So that's kind of where that's at. That's why I did the Penske truck. It has the ramp, which will make it a little easier for offloading, I think. But with all contingencies being what they are, I'm not real sure how that's gonna work out. We'll just have to wait and see when we get it back to the shop, which we're headed that way now.
National Parts Depot offers quality restoration parts for Mustang, Cougar, Camaro, Firebird, Chevelle, GTO, Chevy and Ford trucks, Bronco and Thunderbirds. For quality parts in stock and delivered fast from our four warehouses nationwide, nobody beats NPD's speed and service. For your free catalog, go online or call toll-free. NPD, make your dream happen.
I think this is a really quality product. I mean, you do this kind of stuff. You worked mm-hmm. with these in the shops and stuff, and it looks to me like...
I've worked with professional grade and all the kinds of lifts, and this is just about the same level of it.
I know we were doing pretty well. We put the jack underneath there, and we didn't actually dent the the runways, the jack, picking everything up.
No, so I think it's put together really well.
Yeah, it's a really nice product. I like the weld work on it. Everything looks really good. So I guess the next thing for us to do is... put it in. All right, there are a couple things you're going to need to be mindful of. Whenever you get this thing in, this box right here has all of your small parts and your instruction sheet in it. Don't do like I do and misplace this box, because it will cause you to not be able to put your lift together. One of the other things that we've heard is that sometimes when these things are shipped, in general, shipping companies don't give as much of a crap about your lift as you do. So, if that's the case, things can get knocked out. If this box is missing, you will not be able to assemble your lift, because every small part for the Wildfire lift is right here. Now, the other thing I want to talk about is one of the options that we got for our lift that is not a standard part of it. Cool thing is, like the casters, drip trays, all that stuff comes with the lift, but the jacking bridge that we got does not come as part of the lift, and that's something that I really wanted to have for this, because it's just nice to be able to get the jacking bridge up underneath there with the small bottle jacks inside of it, so you can pop something up in the air if you want to get the front of the car or whatever. The jacking bridge will help you with that. So without further ado, we are going to continue on with the actual install part of this, but I wanted to give you those two tips because of the things that we ran into with our install. All right, one of the first things you'll want to do is you'll want to put a 4x4 underneath your post so that you can get the crossbeam on. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to move up here and put the other slider in position so that this post will slide together with the crossbeam. You want to take the tab, pull it back, and put one of the sliders in here to keep this from... I'm going to move it over a little bit more. You want to put this in here so that the tab won't engage onto the post while you're trying to put this thing together. Now, Cam and I can put this on. This is going to be heavy. All right, we're going to get the crossbeam on. I highly recommend having someone this size helping you. If you don't, two or three guys, you can put this thing together. But a big guy
makes it a lot easier.
Especially if you're old like me. What am I catching on?
All right, I'm gonna go ahead and move my post.
I think this was cookied.
Alright, so while you're sliding the crossbeam down, we have the polylock in to keep the main safety latch on. We'll keep it pulled away from the main post. We need to make sure to pull this secondary safety as well, so that it slides down the rails.
Like butter. It's like butter!
Except it got stuck.
Whoopsie!
Burnt butter. We are going to go to the fifth or the sixth lockout tab. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we're going to go until the primary latch catches it. Right. All right. Now that the poly sliders that are keeping the lock tabs out are out, we can slide it down and engage it. There we go. Okay. Now we can stand the posts up.
Let's get these out of the way so we don't wreck them.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to lift this thing up, get them vertical. White Kaduba. This is why it's good to have big friends. All right, now we're going to do the other one off camera, because basically the procedures on it are the same. So we're just going to go ahead and get that one done. And then we'll show you how to get the ramps on here, which is the next stage of this whole process. Yay. Onward and forward.
All right, so I'm going to go ahead and install the poly sliders onto our main posts. There are two different styles. There are full 90 degrees, and then there are cutoffs. The cutoffs are for the safety latches. You need to be mindful of what kind of cutoff you have. They are side specific. This notch needs to align with the lower safety latch. So this one goes in like this. You just have to move the crossbeam over to accept it, slide it down, slide your full sizes in to get the beam centered. All right, once you have it like this, if it locks up, you can use the second poly slider. you get three in, they pretty much all just wiggle the post a little bit and they should slide down by hand. And this one's being a little bit difficult, so it's gonna take a little rubber mallet. All right, now that we got our poly sliders in, we need to put our brackets in to hold them down, and we're lowering the lift. So slide it right on top, and then we have our little Allen head screws with a lock washer and a flat washer. Just go ahead and start those in. Make sure it's nice and snug. All right, we are good to go to put the ramps on.
All right, now what you're gonna wanna do is you wanna take the four bolts off the top ramp after you get your engine hoist on here with a nice solid strap. We're using a strap, you could possibly use chain, but the strap's gonna be a lot easier on the ramps. Yes, I know, over the course of time, we're gonna scar the piss out of this thing using it, but you still want it nice in the beginning, don't you? So I'm gonna go ahead and get these things off of here. It's a 7/8 inch fastener on both of them. Nice thing is you're running standard, you're not having to run metric. All right, now we've got this thing already up in the air. We use the strap to get it all where we got it. We've got a hammer on here to help steady the weight a little bit. Because right now we're having a problem getting the thing to center weight the way we want to. I mean, I might take this booklet off of here, that's the assembly manual, and it go that way. I don't know. It's a little this way. We'll see what we got. We're gonna try to steady walk this thing in. I'm gonna keep it in the line. I was never an iron worker, so this could get ugly in a hurry. Almost got ugly right away. Whoa. I'm going to keep this one up in the air. Let's just keep it up in the air.
See if we can get it. The train.
Yeah.
It's closer on your side.
So. Yeah. Big holes is what we're shooting for right here. Okay, all right, near it.
Can you go closer to it?
We probably could go closer to it. Your head calls. It's fine.
Okay, let's get this one off. Underneath of it?
Yep. Cool. I'll leave this.
Okay.
I'm into something a little off center. We're going to be putting the grade 8 fasteners in next, and so what we're going to do is hopefully the bolts are really long. So we're going to get a bolt set and then we're going to reset so you guys can see what we're doing. All right, we're going to go ahead and get this last one in here and then we're going to go work on the other end. All right, we're going to roll this thing on its side on our 4x4s. The 18.
Huh? Finish picking it up.
I don't know, bud. That's pretty freaking heavy. All right, we're going to jack this thing up. Now we're going to bring our engine hoist in, and we're going to flip the thing on over from there. This is probably the most dangerous thing you're going to do when you're working with this lift setup, is working with your engine hoist and your runways. Be very careful when you're doing this kind of stuff, because...
stuff happens very quickly.
It does. And this stuff is extremely heavy. These runways, I don't even know how much they weigh independently, But they're heavy.
Oh, close to 1,000.
Okay, close to 1,000. He can't lift 1,000 pounds picking it up like this. He can lift 600-800 pounds that way.
I can pick up one side of him.
He can pick up one side, so he can pick up 400 pounds. Something like that. Anyway, I'm not going to try to do the math. So we're going to get this set up and come back in and show you how we try to roll this thing over. Hopefully it works.
If not, it'll still be on the ground.
Either way, it's on the ground. All right, now what I'm going to do now is we've got this thing up in the air. We're going to show you how to take this and slide it in. We've got the end of this ramp down here over the top. We're going to now pull it down this way, get this end up over the ramp, hopefully. Come to me a little bit.
Yeah, come back.
Okay. Good.
About lined up here.
You're lined up?
That's about, yeah.
Yeah, I'm pretty close here too.
Just drop it down a little
bit. Drop it down a little bit, yeah. Kind of trying to sight this on the back side over here. Noises. One in. All right, now when you're putting this together, you're going to set it up with a washer on the inside plate of the ramp, then you have a lock washer, and then you'll also have your nut. So basically, I'm going to go ahead and get these in. We showed you how to install them a little bit ago. I'm going to go ahead and finish this side up. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, and we've got bolts in all three of the other locations on here on both ends of the ramps. We've taken the bolts out on this end so that we can mount up these. Now these are the plates that hold the ramps and the end caps on the ends of the runways here. And I'm basically just going to put these in position and run the bolts through. And then mount them up with my impact. Now the cool thing is you can put the ramps on either end of this lift. So what that means is you can actually put the car on here, take the ramps, go to the other end, drive the car off the other end of the ramp, if you've got room, and you're good to go. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this up. I'm going to put our washers and nuts on and get these things final tightened in so that we can keep moving with this. All right, we got all the runways set in. Everything's down where it needs to be. So I'm going to go ahead and tighten up all the bolts, finish this up, and then we're going to start moving on to getting the cables and everything installed on this lift. All right, next thing we're going to do is we're going to start hanging cables. I'm going to cut these loose so they can go loosey-goosey. Moving on down the way here. One of the things that they admonish you to not do on this is to not cut the hydraulic line. And I think what they mean by that is not necessarily when you're cutting the zip ties loose. It's basically getting the hydraulic line out of the way when you're doing anything on the lift. So the hydraulic line is kind of tied around this stuff, but that's our last one right there. And now we can start running our cables out to the ends and putting them up on top. The nice thing is you have a built-in ladder. Get up on this thing and get the end caps put up, start putting your cables in. Then you start getting the hydraulics run. Then you can actually run your lift. All right. So if you want to get your cables installed correctly, you're going to have to extend the ram. So you need to have a big guy like Cam on board to do so.
All right, so what you need to do is grab a cable, and we're just gonna use the pulley that's down on the end, pull it tight, and then yank it. The cylinder's full of air right now, so it's not super hard to pull. I don't know if you could hear that, but just let the air bleed out of it. Pull it tight again, keep pressure on it, and just get the cylinder all the way out. And that should be enough to get the cables on. All right, now we are going to go ahead and route our cables. It's pretty simple. You've got four main pulleys up here on the cylinder runway. The bottom one is for the front posts, and the top ones are for the rear posts. So I'm going to go ahead and take the nuts off of this cable, which is for our front, my right hand post. Once you have the nuts off of it, you can take the bolt, route it through the runway. Make sure not to go above this top cable. Pull it out through the runway and just flex the cable, twist it so it'll go through. Once you do, it pops out like that, and then you run it over to the second ramp, which does not have the cylinder in it, and run it through it the same way. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and put the top cap on. Two points on this one. You have to have this hole right here pointing towards the center for the cable, and then also whichever post you want to put your motor on, your pump, which is right by your ram, you have to save the caps that have the four holes drilled and tapped into them for that post. So I'm just gonna reach up. This is where it's really handy to be big. Drop that down and then route the cable. All right, now that we have our post in, I'm gonna take the cable with no nuts on it, push it up through the top and pull it back down towards myself. Then I'm going to take the flat washer, put it on first. Take one nut, run it down to just about the bottom. The second nut, and probably run that just to the middle because we will have to adjust these cables and let it slide back down like that. Now that we have our cable installed into the top plate, I'm going to show you how to route. It goes under this pulley right here and in front of the secondary safety catch. That way when you're raising it, this is always engaged to the post, and if somehow the cable snaps, it will catch the lift tray. That way it doesn't crash to the ground with your car. So next up is installing our safety control levers, and then after that is mounting the pump and getting the system primed.
All right, now we've got the main safety rod running down to the other end of the lift. We've already set up that end, but what I wanted to show you is kind of how this goes together. The big long black rod that you have in here is just for that. It is for the safety devices on this lift. Now what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and clock our main arm at the very front over here into position. We're going to try to get it where we've got a couple threads. That's closed all the way off, so he's going to back it off one or two right there. Now I'm going to take the nut and pull it in. Now I've put that hose up so you can kind of see what we're doing here. And it's going to keep dropping down and into the shot. We'll take a pair of vice grips, grab the main shaft assembly here with that. I'm going to tighten up the nut on here. And the problem you run into sometimes is just what I'm running into. So not enough room. We're now clocked at a 12 o'clock position on the arm itself, and we can now go in and start setting up the rod assemblies on the ends over here. Just that one more step closer to having our lift in and being able to pull a car on it. More importantly, also under it.
Okay, now that we got our control lever threaded into the main rod, I've already got our linkages installed. Now it is recommended to install the long linkage onto the top and the short linkage on the bottom. You can run either or, but running the long one on the top is going to flex the linkage less, and while it's not going to fail immediately, you will be putting additional stress on it, which will induce failure. Now, the front one with the control rod on it is recommended at a 12 to 6 alignment, while the rear one is a 2 to 8. So we've got our rods adjusted to the right length. I've got some of them tightened down already. Just got to tighten up the jam nuts. All right, now I've gotten just about everything tightened up. I recommend installing the rear linkage first. That just makes it a lot easier because you can set it to 2 and 8 pretty easy. And then you can just thread the front one in to 12 o'clock and you're good to go. Just the rods and... So next up is installing the pump and priming the system.
All right, here we go.
Okay, so we are installing the pump bracket. We are shimming it with washers.
joints. It's going to snug these down. So the lock washers are flush. And we are good to mount the pump. All right, so now that we have our mount installed, I'm going to head and install our pump and reservoir. Reservoir goes to the bottom, pump on top. We've got some bolts. I'm going to need Jeff here to come in and put some bolts in for me, just so I don't drop this.
Let's not drop that because it's made of put some plastic on it. And a washer and a nut. Get this one in down here.
Not sure where I am.
All right, now another thing, point of reference on this. When it comes shipped to you, this handle right here is loose. You can caulk this handle with a jam nut to say if you want it like that, or right there, anywhere pretty much. You can caulk it wherever you want and then tighten the jam nut down. So we're going to go just about 90 degrees. Snug the jam nut down. Doesn't have to be gorilla tight. And now our control lever works. So next up is going to be running our hydraulic line. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and get the hydraulic lines run. First thing you need to do is take your line that's underneath, already attached to the cylinder. Take the jam nut off the bulkhead fitting, bring it up here, and put it in the pre-drilled hole. Get the jam nut back on it. Make sure you don't drag the hydraulic fitting through dirt or whatever. That is the number one killer of hydraulics, water intrusion and dirt intrusion, or contaminant intrusion, I should say. Next up is going to be our hydraulic line. It comes with two caps already installed. Only remove one at a time just to be safe. All right, now I've got that line off, or got the cap off. I'll thread it onto the bulkhead fitting. Don't want this tight right now, but I am going to route the line with everything loose. So I'm going to go ahead and set that. And now we have a P-clamp that is going to hold this line, but we have to remove the screw that we installed earlier. All right. Now when you're routing this line, you want to make sure that it stays off the cable, that's not on it. We got pretty good clearance, so I'm happy enough with that. So next up is going to be a straight fitting on the other side that goes onto the pump itself. Alright, to install this, you remove this yellow cap right here that is on the manifold block of your pump. Then you have a O-ring and you have a flare side. The O-ring side goes towards the manifold block of your pump. Thread that in, snug it down, you don't have to go crazy. Remove your cap from the other side of the line. You want to have this 90 degree going with the manifold block and pointing towards the runways. All right, we can go ahead and snug this side of the line up and the straight fitting as well. All right, and now we are good to go ahead and fill our reservoir, plug it in, start priming.
Actually do one heck of a Thanksgiving here.
So there are a couple things that we do need to go over. One, you make sure that you don't keep running the system after the first prime. What's going to happen is when you lower the ramp, lower the runways all the way, all the air that was in that cylinder is going to go into your reservoir and aerate your fluid. When we did it, we had about 1 inch of solid fluid and then the rest of it was just milky aerated. And that will aerate the pump and do some damage, so we're going to leave it overnight all the way down. That pushes all the fluid that we can into the reservoir, and throughout the night it will bleed out. What else we got?
Well, we had some covers that we put on mm-hmm. that were not on there when we were doing the bleed outs and stuff. We got our jacking tray in there, which I'm really excited about that. We got to put the brakes on it.
Yeah.
but that's just little detail-y stuff. Yeah. Compared to what we've done so far, that's almost nothing. I mean, we can caster it up and roll it around inside the shop. I'm really hoping we've got enough room that I don't have to do any kind of mods to get it around that corner to where it's actually going to
live.
Yeah, it's going to live over in that corner, so
we'll see.
We'll see. And if nothing else, we've got a spot right here. Yeah. We had talked about this. The cool thing about the lift
is we can now fit two cars in this bay, at least.
Yeah, we could put two cars in this bay. It's also going to allow us to be able to work either back over there, or we'll be able to pull a car in here. We may not be able to stand up underneath the car, but we'll be able to work underneath the car.
Better than being on your back.
Yeah, and trying to shoot that stuff has always been a problem. The main goal behind the lift for me...
Easier shooting.
Just a lot easier shooting. And with my back and your back, a lift's going to help us being able to do some of the things that we need to do. All right, folks. Well, that's our episode for this week. Now, I wanted to tell you, there's a few things I want you to do. Go out and like and subscribe to the videos. Hit that bell. Ring that clown so that you can be notified of everything that we do on the show. If you don't ring that bell, you're going to have no idea, because there's so much stuff being put on YouTube every day. You're not going to know. Another thing I want you to go is go down and do something in the comments. Just comment to us what you thought about the video, anything you might want us to do in the future or looking at us doing. We will answer your comments. I am really good about being able to go in and hit that stuff. You can also email us and all that, but in the comments section is where I spend most of my time. If you'll notice, I don't let it go too long without answering questions from viewers. And now that my mobile phone has somehow enabled the thing where I get notifications on YouTube, by Gumby, I just can't escape. So you can get me anywhere in the world now. Another thing I'd like for you to do is, if we have done anything to help you out with your car, go out and check out our Patreon account that we have out there. We've got a link in the description below. You can go out there, you can do a monthly thing. We're gonna be starting up this month, toward the end of the month, a thing where you can do a one-time gift, because we finally got some round two-its coming.
Yep.
We're doing round two-its with the Gasoline Media logo on one side and the round two-it information on the back, so you have then no excuse to get your car done. And we'll be putting up the information for what that is on our Gasoline Media site on Patreon. If we've helped you out at all, if you help us out, it'll help us feed the kids. Because the kids, oh my gosh, every Saturday they wipe me out. I have no food left. I have to go buy new groceries after they get through eating after we threw
them. The sad part is it's not even me. I eat less than all of them.
It's like, they're like, ah. He's just over here like daintily cutting his stuff up with a fork and a knife.
It's ridiculous.
It's terrible. There's stuff on the walls behind the kids, and he's just sitting over there going, anyway, that's our show for this week. As I said before, you guys have a great week, and we'll see you next time on Autorestomod.
I'm going to go home, coach.
Get out of here.